We do this in whole class, and they also do it in stations where they're collaborating with each other. They work out the problem step by step, and they make sure each other, they have to have it right. Everybody has to agree on the answer before they actually select an answer. And the reason I have incorporated this is just to make sure that learning is fun. Our students use so much technology at home that we've just decided to use it in the class. And so just to make it a little bit more fun for them. Carlos, you can go ahead and start. So they're going to solve a problem for you, and they're going to do 9 tenths times 8 tenths.
5th grade is going to start first, and then 4th grade will follow.
Okay, so once they all agree they got the answer right, then it takes them to another answer. If they got the answer wrong, it would then explain to them why their answer is wrong and what answer would be the correct answer.
Now, they did get the answer right, correct?
Yes.
And they'll say, that's okay. So
that's okay to this computer means it's right. Our that's okay means it's not, but.
So now, Carlos, you'll close off your iPad, and then a fourth grade word problem or math problem will show up.
Good.
That's Ms. Chandler's daughter.
Yes.
Okay, so what we're going to do is find the number, we're going to divide each of these numbers by 3, so each one doesn't have a remainder.
And so in fourth grade, what we started using this with is division. Division is a hard sell. And so what I like about this is it's really engaging, and they're collaborating, and they're having fun. And it's not like pulling teeth. They get to work it out. And Bradley's all about it. He's like, I'm on it. I'm going. And the kids just all come together, and they're like, let me do some more. Let me do more problems. And putting that technology in their hands just makes a world of difference. So they want to do it. And it's really exciting for them.
And the collaboration in a small group, the kids really like, and it's easy to check for understanding with the teacher. She walks around and makes corrections.
So much enough
you
guys
are
doing. So
we can't be just first number because it has to be number 2. So I'm going to drop it to 2.
And we can't control the problems that go up there. They are grade level, and so some are easy, some are very difficult.
And it even will put word problems up there, so it'll give them a word problem, and they have to figure out what type of problem it is and work it out. So it just is a multitude. It just, you know, randomizes, and we get what we get.
I'm sorry, this is because we can't control it. It just
says which number is divisible by 3, and our answer choices are 56, 52, 49, and 75.
Oh, okay.
So if I did it 75,
okay, so they got that problem right, and then they would move to the next problem, and then the teachers go around and check for understanding, and they look at the whiteboard and so forth. Thank you.
Ms. Sheila.
I like that. Yes, sir.
How did Mr. Bipper do?
He did okay.
I went about it a little different way than he did, but
yeah. You learned it like I did on stone tablet.
He did not have all the words that Brad did, and he didn't have it all, but he got it.
Didn't show all the steps.
And so they're gonna log out of this, and then the last thing we're gonna do is
hold on.
Okay.
So really quickly, just to show, here's the back of you. If the students get in my classroom, if we do it whole group, they all have to answer a question, and I have about 20 students. And then they get a chance to play these games, which you can see up there. That's kind of an incentive for working the problem out and really working hard. If they're in a station, there's usually four students in each station or center, and they each have to answer two questions correctly, and then they each get to play the game, a round of the game. And so this is a really good incentive, and they really like the game. And I even play it for them, and they laugh at me because I'm not very good at games. Because you have to tilt the iPad. You want to show them real quick the race car game? And so it turns sideways up here, but he has to maneuver the iPad in order to keep from hitting the parked car. And so it just makes the learning that much more fun.
Is this a software package, or is this something, or are you accessing something online? Or?
These are apps that the teachers have found and so forth.
Okay.
And some have purchased and so forth. Yes, sir.
Okay.
So what we're going to do now is I want to show you, at Forestville North as well as our other campuses, we do a good job of sharing our best practices, teaching strategies, whether it's innovative or whether it's inventive lessons. And so we've created a video file of teachers that are doing